द कॉल माता जी, हरे कृष्णा।
हरे कृष्णा निहारिका माता जी, धन्यवाद प्रणाम। प्लीज एक्सेप्ट माय हम्बल ऑब्लिगेशंस। ऑल गोइस टू शिला प्रभुपाद एंड गुरु महाराज। दिस इज राधा रानी फ्रॉम बाल्टीमोर।
हरे कृष्णा राधा रानी माता जी, धन्यवाद प्रणाम। ऑल गोइस टू शिला प्रभुपाद एंड गुरु महाराज। थैंक यू सो मच फॉर जॉइनिंग द कॉल माता जी, हरे कृष्णा।
हरे कृष्णा निहारिका माता जी, प्लीज एक्सेप्ट माय हम्बल ऑब्लिगेशंस। ऑल गोइस टू शिला प्रभुपाद एंड ऑल गोइस टू गुरुदेव। दिस इज राधा फ्रॉम बाल्टीमोर।
हरे कृष्णा राधा माता जी, धन्यवाद प्रणाम। ऑल ग्रोस श्रील प्रभुपाद एंड गुरु महाराज। थैंक यू सो मच फॉर जॉइनिंग द कॉल माता जी, हरे कृष्णा।
कृष्णा निहारिका माता जी, धन्यवाद प्रणाम। श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय, गुरु महाराज की जय। दिस इज श्यामा गौरी दासी फ्रॉम शार्लेट।
हरे कृष्णा श्यामा गौरी माता जी, धन्यवाद प्रणाम। ऑल ग्लोरी टू श्रील प्रभुपाद एंड गुरु महाराज। थैंक यू सो मच फॉर जॉइनिंग द कॉल माता जी, हरे कृष्णा।
कीर्तन मूवमेंट एंड राधा कृष्ण आशीष की, थैंक यू वेरी मच। हरे कृष्णा, दिस इज कमलती दासी।
हरे कृष्णा माता जी, धन्यवाद प्रणाम। ऑल ग्लोरी टू श्रील प्रभुपाद एंड गुरु महाराज। थैंक यू सो मच फॉर योर एसोसिएशन दिस मॉर्निंग माता जी, थैंक यू सो मच। हरे कृष्णा। Is there anybody else who would like to listen to this morning?
हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे राम 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 हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे राम 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 हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे राम 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 हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे राम 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 हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे राम 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 हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे राम 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 हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे राम 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 हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे राम 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 हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे राम 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 हरे कृष्ण हरे राम 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 हरे हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे राम 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 हरे कृष्ण हरे राम 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 हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे राम 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 हरे हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे राम 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 हरे
हरे राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे हरे
कृष्ण माताजी प्रभु जी इज ऑन द कॉल
वेलकम टू भक्ति संघ कॉन्फ्रेंस कॉल टुडे वी आर वेरी फॉर्चुनेट टू हैव हिज ग्रेस कमल लोचन प्रभु जी प्रभुजी धन्यवाद ऑल श्री प्रभुपाद एंड गुरु महाराज Thank you very so much for giving your valuable time and association to us this morning, Prabhuji, on the topic of Srimad Bhagavatam, 4th Canto, 30th chapter, verse 25th onwards. Prabhuji, I will hand over the call to you. Hare Krishna.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयामुदीरयेत् नष्टप्रायेष भद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवय भगवती उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम कैंटो 4 चैप्टर 30 टेक्स्ट नंबर 25 नमः कमलनाभाय नमः कमलमालिने नमः कमलपादाय नमस्ते कमलेक्षण नमः कमलनाभाय नमः कमलनाभाय नमः कमलमालिने नमः कमलमालिने नमः कमलपादाय नमः कमलपादाय नमस्ते कमलेक्षण नमस्ते कमलेक्षण नमः कमलनाभाय नमः कमलनाभाय नमः कमलमालिने नमः कमलपादाय नमस्ते ते कमलेक्षण वर्ड टू वर्ड मीनिंग नमः वी ऑफर आवर रेस्पेक्टफुल ओबीशियंसेस कमलनाभाय ऑन टू द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉडहेड from whose abdomen the original lotus flower originated. Namaha, obeisances, Kamalamaline, one who is always decorated with a garland of lotus flowers. Namaha, obeisances, Kamalanabhadaya, whose feet are as beautiful and fragrant as a lotus flower. Namaste, obeisances unto you, Kamalekshana, whose eyes are exactly like the petals of the lotus flower. Translation in purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Dear Lord, we offer our respectful obeisances unto you because from your abdomen sprouts the lotus flower, the origin of all living entities. You are always decorated with a lotus garland. And your lotus feet resemble the lotus flower with all its fragrance. Your eyes are also like the petals of the lotus flower. Therefore, we always offer our respectful obeisances unto you. Purport. The word Kamalanabhaya indicates that Lord Vishnu is the origin of the material creation. From the abdomen of Garbhodakshya Vishnu, a lotus flower sprouts. Lord Brahma, the first creature of the universe is born from this lotus flower. And subsequently, Lord Brahma creates the whole universe. The origin of all creation is therefore Lord Vishnu. The origin of all the Vishnu tattvas is Lord Krishna. Consequently, Krishna is the origin of everything. It is also confirmed in Bhagavad Gita 10.8. Aham sarvasya prabhavo matta sarvam pravartate iti matva bhajante mam buddha bhava samanvita. I am the source of all spiritual and material worlds. Everything emanates from me. The wise who perfectly know this engage in my devotional service and worship me with all their hearts. Lord Krishna says, I am the origin of everything. Therefore, whatever we see emanates from him. This is also confirmed in the Vedanta Sutras, Janmadhyasyataha. The absolute truth is he from whom everything emanates. Omagyad virandasya gyananjana shalakaya chakshurun militam yena tasmai shri gurave nama shri chaitanya manobishtam stapitam yena bhutale svayam rupak dameham dadati swahadantikam vandeham shri guru shri uta padakamalam shri gurun vishnavamsya shri rupam sakrajatam sahagana raghunathanvitam tam sajivam साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजन सहितं कृष्ण चैतन्य देवं श्री राधा कृष्ण पादान सकल दुःखाश्च विशाखामितांश्च हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधो दीनबंधो जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत स्तुते तत्त कांचन गौरंगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिय वाञ्छाकल्पितरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृन्द हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे सो करेंटली वी आर डूइंग द प्रेयर्स बाय द पचेतस नाउ वी नो पचेतस दे सैंग द रुद्र गीता मेनी मेनी टाइम्स. So practically they chanted for Lord Shiva's prayers for 10,000 years. Dasavarsha sahastrante purushastu samatmanaha desham avirabhut kricham. So after chanting this Rudra Gita for 10,000 years, just imagine. That's so powerful this Rudra Gita is. The Lord appeared in front of them. And as soon as Lord appeared in front of the Prachetas, what happened? Because when you do austerity, you'll be so tired. Immediately, Shanten Samayanducha. They all became, all the problems, all the trouble, all the exertion, it became mitigated, became very peaceful and energized. Just by looking at the beautiful form of Krishna. Now, how is the form of Krishna? Krishna came on the Garuda. And Garuda was golden color. It is Krishna appearing like the peak on the Mount Meru. In this way, beautiful forms of Krishna are described. So, Krishna started speaking to the Prachetas. He told the Prachetas that, oh, I am very much pleased with you. Why? Because of Sauhrudenavaha, Tushtoham Sauhrudenavaha. So when you are very much having good relationship with us, especially brothers, sisters, god brothers, god sisters, and people in general, because of your gentle behavior, Krishna becomes pleased by your gentle behavior. He said the same thing. He says, Tushtoham Sahurudenava. He could have told, I'm pleased by your prayers. More than that, Krishna told him, I'm pleased by your prayer, by your friendship, Sahurudenava. And then he goes on further. He says, anybody who remembers you all, it's a very great benediction. Anybody remembers the Pachetas. You anusparanti sandhyayam. It is evening here in India. The morning is going on. Especially sandhyayam in the evening time. Anybody will, who remembers the Prachetas daily in the evening, he will have friendship to everyone. Yusman nanudinam naraha tasya bhratrishtu atmasamyam. He will have bhratritva. That means he brotherhood to everyone. And he will have close friendship with everyone. Tata bhuteshu surudam. Not only with others, with his brothers also, there will be a lot of friendship. So we have a big problem in the world now. We have everything except relationships. The relationships are not proper. You find the closest relationship, the husband and wife are fighting every day. Brothers are fighting among themselves. Brothers and sisters are fighting. Sometimes the father and son are fighting with each other. Mother and daughter fighting with each other. What to speak of neighbors, even within our own house. There's so much of fight going on, so much of klesha. You have a big bungalow, so many dollars, a lot of wealth, but no peace at home because they're fighting. People don't go along with each other. There's no friendship. There's no saurudatva. So it is more relevant now that we remember the Prachetas, talking about the Prachetas. Now we should know these Prachetas, they did the Rudra Gita, chanting of the Rudra Gita for 10,000 years in Guruvayurappan, in Guruvayur. It's a very beautiful place in South India and Kerala. Most of you must have visited. If you have not visited, next time when you come to India, visit this place, Guruvayur. That is the place Rudra Gita was chanted. There's Mamyur Shiva. There's Rudra Tirtha also there. And there's Parvati there in the campus, in the temple of Guruvayurappan, having Vatsalya towards Krishna there in Guruvayurappan. And the deity of Guruvayurappan was originally worshipped by Krishna in Dwaraka. And from that Krishna in Dwaraka, he worshipped one form, 400 form of Krishna. So that form came to Guruvayur by Guru and Vayu brought them, and Parashuram welcomed them. And Lord Shiva told that I want to give my place for the Lord. And he shifted to the other side of Rudra Gita. So now he's staying in Mamyur. Shiva is staying in Mamyur. He's known as Mamyur Shiva. And here Guru Vairappan is there. So he also says, because you accepted your father's order, Eduyam Pitru Adesham. Listening to your father is very important. Then that gave a lot of joy for me. That gave a lot of fame to you because you listened to your father. And he goes on telling, you will have a son who is as famous as Brahma. And he will fill the three worlds with all the offerings. In this way, he talks about you should get married to Vanakanya, the trees. The trees, they have a daughter. And she was born from Kannu Maharshi. Kannukund. There is one place called Kannukund near Kasargod. And fortunately, we have a ISKCON temple nearby. Means we just got land many years back. Somehow he was instrumental in getting a piece of land for ISKCON. So that place is near Kannukund, and that is the place the Prachetas met Kannu Maharshi. And they got married to his daughter. So, and then Krishna says to the Prachetas that you should rule the world and enjoy all the material opulences, all the material pleasures. Ultimately, you give up. Ultimately, you give up and then engage yourself in pure devotional service ultimately, and you can come back to me, the spiritual world. He says, Greshu Avishatam Chapi. Somebody may say, oh, you're asking us to enter into the Grihastha Ashrama. And by entering into the Grihastha Ashrama, you'll get bound again to material happiness. He says, no, don't worry about it. Those Grihasthas, Griheshu Avishatam Chapi, Umsam Kushala Karmanam. Umsam Kushala Karmanam. Even though you have entered the Grihastha Ashrama, but if you are engaged yourself in devotional service and spending your time madvartha yata yamanam, if you are constantly discussing madvartha, my pastimes, what happens? Na bandhaya grihamata, there will be no bondage because of your grihastha life. So one should practice pure devotional service. At the same time, spending all the time practically in discussing about Krishna. At that time, na bandhaya grihamata, there will be no bondage. So very interesting here to know that how is it that Krishna is telling the Pratyutas to enter the Grihastha Ashrama, rule the world, enjoy the material opulence. For that, we should know that there are two kinds of material enjoyment. One material enjoyment is like hell, and other enjoyment, material enjoyment, one kind of material enjoyment is like hell, and it is not favorable for bhakti. And there's another kind of material enjoyment. What is that? That is favorable for bhakti, because that is coming from the mercy of Krishna. So, enjoyment produced out of the bond of karma causes bondage. And that is hellish, and that is unfavorable for bhakti. On the other hand, there is a material enjoyment arising from the mercy of Krishna. And that material enjoyment, which is coming from the mercy of Krishna, that is favorable for bhakti. That is what Krishna tells Pratyutas. The enjoyment which I am giving you by my mercy, that enjoyment increases your bhakti, that should not be given up. So, the material enjoyment given by Krishna, which is arising from the mercy of Krishna, that does not cause bondage. Now, examples are there. What are the examples? Yaprithu Maharaj actually wanted to give up, but still, of course, his incarnation of Krishna himself. But Yaprithu Maharaj ruled the entire earth, enjoyed the earth, earthly kingdom. He was king of the entire earth. Prahlad Maharaj, just imagine. And the kind of instructions at the age of 5 he gave, extreme vairagya. Anybody who reads Prahlad's teachings, they will just give up the house immediately and then go to the forest, or go to some temple and become a brahmachari or sannyasi. But after that, what did Prahlad Maharaj do? He told Narasimha, told you had ruled. Dhruv Maharaj, he compared the desire what he had for the kingdom to be broken piece of glasses. But Krishna told, no, you should become the king. Manu Maharaj, he was such a great renunciate, he made him enjoy this kingdom. So there is a material enjoyment which increases bhakti. There is a material enjoyment which is actually mercy of Krishna. And those who are not qualified for that material enjoyment. And if they have the material enjoyment, what did Krishna do? He takes away. So Krishna's mercy is in two ways. Those who are qualified for material enjoyment, he gives them material enjoyment, and that is mercy of Krishna. That is favorable for bhakti. But those who are having impurities in the heart, for them, Krishna shows mercy by taking away the material enjoyment. Yasya aham manugrahanami harishyeta dharam shanaihi. Very interesting. Krishna gives material enjoyment for those people who are pure at heart. And that material enjoyment which Krishna is giving, that is his mercy, and that increases their bhakti further. But those who are not pure at heart, what does Krishna do? He takes away the material enjoyment from them. And that, in that way, shows mercy. So Krishna's mercy is of two kinds. One is giving material enjoyment, that is also mercy. Taking away material enjoyment, that is also mercy. How does he take material enjoyment and shows mercy? To those people who are not pure at heart. But whom does he give material enjoyment and opulence? To those people, those devotees who are pure at heart. Purified completely. For them he gives, and that increases their bhakti. So this is how the Chetas, they are told by Krishna. In this way, the Prachetas, they started worshipping Krishna. They started glorifying Krishna. Namo Ramat Klesha Vinashaya. 22nd verse. Namo Ramat Klesha Vinashanaya. We pay obeisances again and again to you, O Lord, your Klesha Vinashanaya. You are the destroyer of all the difficulties, Kleshas. Nirupito dara guna havaya guna vara vahaya. So you have got many names and qualities. Actually, this all the Vedic literature, practically every word in the Veda is nothing but the glorification of Krishna. Adhyecha madhyecha antyecha sarvatra harer kiyate. And then namo vacho vega puro javaya. Now, nobody can actually describe you, because the moment you describe about Krishna, Krishna is more than what you describe. Krishna is much superior to what you have described him about. What you have described him, Krishna is more superior. So you cannot catch Krishna by your words. Suppose you think Krishna is so big. So he's bigger than what you think as big. Krishna is so beautiful. So Krishna is more beautiful than what all you can think about. That is why he said, Namo Vacho Vega Puro Javaya. And Sarva Krishna Marge Agadavane Namaha. Nobody can understand Krishna by their senses. They go down further. Shuddhaya Shantaya Namasvanishthaya. He is pure, peaceful, and he is always fixed up in his Swarupa. Manas Abartham Vilasadvayaya. And especially for those who are devoted to Krishna, they become completely neutral to all the dualities. Happiness, misery. Happiness comes, no problem. Misery comes, no problem. They are safe. Somebody praises, okay. Doesn't praise, okay. Criticizes, okay. Doesn't criticize, okay. Bothers, okay. Doesn't bother, okay. So they are in the platform of not being disturbed by the dualities. And what happens, Krishna, though he is a transcendental form, he accepts the forms of Brahma, Indra, Ashakti, Avesh, Avatar. That is why Maya, Guna, Vigrahaya, Grihita, Maya. He accepts. Krishna, he accepts material form, though he is transcendental form. And then, Namo Vishuddha Sattvaya. Krishna is having a transcendental form. Vishuddha Sattvaya. His form is full of goodness, pure goodness. Hare Hare Medase, Hare Hari Medaste. What does it do? Hare, he removes, he destroys all the material sufferings. And Vasudevaya Krishnaya, and he's got wonderful names. His name is Vasudeva, Hari, Krishna. Prabhave Sarvasatpatam. And he's the Lord of all the devotees, Sarvasatpata. Now, after paying obeisances in these few verses, or when somebody surrenders, he goes into ecstasy. In the ecstatic mood, Namasankirtan happens. Now, if you see in the previous verse, Namasankirtan has happened. There is a system in which most of the prayers, practically all the prayers, are done. Bhagavatam. First is surrender. When you surrender, you become qualified to glorify Krishna. Then comes glorification. You go on glorifying Krishna, then what happens? After some time, prema manifests in your heart. When love for Krishna, Krishna prema manifests, at that time become totally bewildered. There is no other alternative other than the holy names. You just cannot describe glories of Krishna further. You go on chanting Krishna's name. You can't go on chanting Krishna's name. And that is what happened in the Damodara Ashtakam also. If you see the prayers, Namo, Namami, Ishwaram, Namami, what does it mean? Surrender. Ishwaram, Namami, Ishwaram, Satchidananda Rupam, Lasatkundanam, Gokule, Vrajavaram. It goes on. And there one time when the devotee has no other shelter other than the names of Krishna. Namo Ananta. Namo Deva Damodar Ananta Vishnu. So first is surrender, then glorification. When the glorification is there, at that time, Dainya manifests in the heart. What is that Dainya? Dainya means extreme experience of uselessness. I am so useless, I am so unfit. And in that heart of Dinata, prema manifests. And prema manifests, you want to glorify, but what else you can glorify? You don't know what to glorify about. You don't know how to glorify. And there's only one shelter at that time, which is chanting the names of Krishna. Rama Sankirtan. The same way here also you'll find, first is surrender, glorification, experience of humility, prema manifest, Rama Sankirtan has happened. When the Nam Sankirtan happens, then go on paying obeisances again and again and again. If you see Damodara Ashtakam there, what happens? Chatavritti Vande. I pay my obeisances again and again, hundreds of times. There is an ecstasy of prema. You pay obeisances, you forget your pay obeisances. Again you pay obeisances. Here in this particular verse, 25th verse today, Namakkamalanabhaya. Namak Kamala Malini, Namak Kamala Badaya, Namaste Kamalekshana. Four Namahas and Nabhaya, Krishna's navel has been compared to a flower, a lotus flower. Now we'll talk about comparisons. Comparison. How can you compare Krishna? Krishna's eye is to be lotus. Is it really so? Can you really compare? Is it practical to really compare like this? Krishna's face to lotus, eyes to be the lotus. Krishna's form is transcendental. How can you compare with something material? That is a question. Now, for that, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he gives a very nice description. Answer to this question in Jaiva Dharma. Jaiva Dharma is a very interesting book in which Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is talking about this particular thing. Uh, That is, how is it possible for a living entity to compare or even talk about the Supreme Lord? Because he's beyond words. Yato vacho nivartante aprapya manasasaha. Speech and mind written from the Supreme Lord, unable to attain him. That is what Upanishad says, Taittiriya Upanishad. Then how are we describing Krishna? And when we describe Krishna, you have to compare Krishna with something what you already know. Then how can you do that? Especially when we say Krishna is like sun and the living entities are the sparks of the sun, isn't it? While trying to explain Achintya Bheda Veda Tattva, we talk about Krishna to be sun and Krishna's, we living entities are like the spark of the sun. How is it so that we can compare Krishna to the sun? Is Krishna like sun? And for that, it is a description. No. Krishna is much more superior to sun. Krishna is much more superior than sun. You just cannot say, Krishna is sun. But how can you say that Krishna is sun? Sun is material and Krishna is spiritual. And how can you just compare with them? Why is comparison is made? Since Krishna is transcendental, why is comparison is made? Further, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur says that whatever statements we give in this material world, all statements will have defects. Any statement you talk about Krishna will have defect in it. Why? Because we have to use material examples. If you say Krishna has got lotus eyes, it is a wrong statement. But what else we can do? We are helpless. We are obliged to use these examples because we are helpless. This is a statement of Bhakti. Just we are helpless. We just cannot. Actually, when we say Krishna is like sun, Krishna is like lotus, his face is like lotus, or his feet are like lotus, it is an insult to Krishna. It is like passing stool and urine on Krishna. Far. In very beautiful prasanga. One of the great acharyas in Sri Sampradaya, after Ramanuja, he became an acharya, Uttarashara Bhatta. Range Sri Rangesha Purohitaha. He is Rangesha Purohitaha. Ranganatha accepted Parashara Bhatta as his Purohita. Parashara Bhatta and Vyasa Bhatta, two small babies, they were taken care by Ranganatha. Ranganayaki in Srirangam temple in the altar. They had a cradle. They're being cradled by Ranganatha and Ranganayaki. That is a great message. He wrote one book called Stava, Rangaraja Stava, glorifying Ranganatha in Srirangam. When he started glorifying, he felt so humble and told, "Oh Lord, how can this mouth glorify you? Because any glorification is actually insult for you. No words can describe you. And I'm describing. How dare I am doing that? Actually, I'm not supposed to, because any description will come to if I say you are like this, but you are much more than that. But if I say something, it will be insult for you. Malini karoti. It is only making you dirty. My words are only blasphemy for you. My words will only make you dirty. But still I will do. But still I'll glorify you. Why? Because you're a merciful Lord. Because you're a very merciful. you are allowing me to do. And you will not feel bad about it. Rather, you will be very happy, even though I am dirtying your swarupa by my words. Like mother. Mother, she is keeping the baby in the lap. What does the baby do? Passes stool and urine. The mother doesn't see it as stool and urine. The mother feels it is fragrance. She experiences the fragrance. She experiences stool and urine as fragrance. Because of her compassion and vatsalya for the baby. Oh Lord, you have such compassion for us. That is why even though I am actually glorifying you, that actually is not your glory. It is actually like stool and urine. I'm vomiting stool and urine onto your swarupa. But still it is your great compassion that you take it as your fragrance. You take my glorification, which are actually like stool and urine, as fragrance because of Rivatsalya. So same thing Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, we are obliged to use these examples. We are helpless without them. Therefore, try to know. In reality, Krishna is far superior to sun, far superior to lotus. He's beyond mind and words. Avang managochara, vang managochara. Actually, examples can only explain limited qualities, but not all. And that too, to give an idea. Like when we say milk is like water. Milk and water both same or what? Now, we are saying as much as the water, the milk is liquid, in the same way water is also liquid. Liquidity has been just compared, that's all. And that in Sanskrit is known as Arundhati Nyaya. To show a star which is very faint, we cannot really see by eyes. You show a star which is very bright. And say, you can see that star? Okay, just near that, that's all. In the same way, what is bright for us is the material objects like lotus, sun, etc., the moon, the sun, moon, lotus, medicine, nectar. These are certain comparisons we do. Use these examples to describe. Because we have no other way, no other choice for us. This is what we can perceive. So somewhat you show Arundhati star, there's a star close by, and you say, oh, this is Arundhati, that's all. It's known as Arundhati Nyaya. So no transcendental thing, transcendental Swarupa of Krishna cannot be described by any material object. It just happens because there is some kind of similarity. That is why we use these things. Now, we'll try to see a few verses where Krishna's beauty, though in this verse we say it is compared to lotus, compared to something, many other verses, but it is much more beyond. So there are a few beautiful verses I'll try to speak from. One book called Vidagdha Madhava, written by Srila Rupa Goswami. Let's see what Vidagdha Madhava, Rupa Goswami says. In verse number 17, first chapter, this verse is spoken by Purnamasi. In Vidagdha Madhava. Anyam nayana dandita parva pundarika prabha. Ayam nayana dandita parva pundarika prabha. Prabhati namaja guda dyuti vidambi vitambaraha. Aranyaja parikshitya damita divya veda. Veshodharo हरिन्मये मनोहरद्युतिभिर् उज्ज्वलाङ्गु हरिः अयम् नयनः पौर्णमासी सेइंग अयम् नयनः दीस ब्यूटिफुल आईज ऑफ कृष्णा दीस आईज यू कैन सी दीस आईज ऑफ कृष्णा दंडित प्रवर पुंडरीक प्रभा दंडित मीन्स इट डिस्ट्रॉयज इट सरपासेस इट डिस्ट्रॉयज दीस वर्ड्स प्रवर पुंडरीक प्रभा पुंडरीक मीन्स द ब्यूटी ऑफ लोटस is destroyed by the eyes of Krishna. It is not explained here as, oh, Krishna has lotus eyes. No. The eyes of Krishna have destroyed the beauty of the lotus. What you know as beauty in this world becomes destroyed by the beauty of Krishna. So don't try to compare Krishna's eyes with any lotus anymore now. And what else you can do? That is why you say we are helpless. So we say Kamala Lochan or Kamala Nayan, like in this verse also, Padma Lochan, all these things, just because we are helpless. But that doesn't mean Krishna's eyes are like lotus. Just to say Krishna's eyes are beautiful, and what beauty you know in this world is that maxim to that is in the lotus only. That is what we compare. That is why Purnamasi says, I am Nayana Dandita Pravara Vandari Kaprabha. What is Krishna wearing? Oh, he's got beautiful silk garments. Huh? Let us see what. Prabhati Navaja Guda Dhyuti Vidam Vipitambaraha. Pitambara of Krishna. The yellow garments, Pitambara, it surpasses the brilliance of the fresh decorations of Kumkum. What do you find Kumkum? Kumkum, all of you know. Actually, these days, what you get Kumkum is actually not real Kumkum. It is only chemical. The real Kumkum we saw in our village, we used to make in our own house. We used to grow turmeric and we had cows to take ghee and make kumkum. Kumkum, you put turmeric and ghee becomes kumkum. So the color is something very wonderful. But Krishna's garments are something beyond that. The color of kumkum itself is so wonderful. But Krishna's garments are beyond that. Prabhati Navaja Guda Dhyuti. So the fresh kumkum is actually more wonderful, more lustrous. I don't know how many of you have seen the manufacturing of making of the fresh kumkum. The fresh kumkum is like, oh, how it is. The redness is totally different. It just cannot be imagined what kind of thing it is. What you see in the market is all just color, chemical. The real kumkum is, you just cannot even imagine. But that itself becomes useless in front of Krishna's Pitambara Vastra. So the Pitambara of Krishna is not the thing what you find in this world. The mixture of Haldi and Kumkum. No, it's not like that. And Aranya Parikshkriya Damita Divyava Veshadharo. And his ornaments are so wonderful that it is beyond. He has got ornaments, his forest flowers, beautiful. Aranya pari harimani manohara dyutir ujjwalango harihi. He possesses a beautiful attracting splendor greater than the jewels known as marakattamani. Going further in the we'll go to the 167th verse. Kulavaradanu dharma garva Vrindanividham. Now, no, not 167, sorry, 168. 168. Just talk about the beauty or not the other verses. Mahendra Mani Mandali Vadavidam Videhadyuter Rajendra Kula Chandra Mas Puradiko Pinavyo Navyo Yuva Sakistira Gulangana Nikara Nivivandar Gala Chidakarna Kautuki Jayati Yasyavam Shidvani. No, Mahendra Mani Mandali Madavidam Videhadyutir. This verse is spoken by Lalita Devi to Srimati Radharani. She is actually describing Krishna. She says, "Do you see this Krishna? This youthful Krishna, who is he? He is Vrajendra Kula Chandrama. He is Vrajendra Kula Chandrama. Vrajendra Nanda Maharaj in the dynasty of Nanda Maharaj. His beauty actually defies all the beauty of the jewels. Mahendra Mani. Mani means jewels. And Mahendra, topmost of the king of all the jewels. Mandali, not one or two. All the jewels you put together, the king of all the jewels, everything you just put together. Their mother vidambi dehatyute. If you say Krishna's body is as beautiful as the topmost jewels, any jewel you bring all the jewels, Krishna's body luster is like that. Nice, wonderful jewel. No, no, no. The pride of the jewels. They're destroyed by the bodily luster of Krishna. That is beyond. Now, going further about Radharani. Somebody may say, what about Radharani? Even her beauty is also is incomparable. You cannot compare with anything in this world. 169. Antarira. Chapter 169.
Baladakshanam Lakshmi Kalayati Navyam Ku. Baladakshanam Lakshmi Kavalayati Navyam Kula Kuvalayam. Mukola Savullam Kamalavaram Ullanghayati Cha. Nastam dashtam aspadam apinayata angi karuchir vichitram radhaya kimapikilam rupam vilasati.
Now, the beauty of Radharani's eyes is described. How it is described?
Baladakshano lakshmi kavalayati navyam kuvalayam.
The lotus flower. And the two eyes of Radharani, what they do? They completely kavalayati, destroy the beauty of the lotus flower. So to say that Radharani's eyes are like blue lotus flower, it is an insult to Radharani. So if at all you can describe beauty of Radharani's, the beauty of Radharani's eyes are such a thing that it destroys the beauty of the lotus flower, the blue lotus flower. If at all there is any pride for the lotus flower, the pride is destroyed. The lotus flower is thinking, I am so beautiful. The pride is destroyed by the beauty of Radharani's eyes. Even if you say, the moment you compare Krishna and Radharani's transcendental form to matter, it is an insult for them. And that is why the Upanishads actually talk about Krishna having no form, Krishna having no eyes, Krishna having no hands, apani padav. Why is they talking about it? They're just talking about it just because we should get rid of the material concept of the absolute truth. If you say Krishna's eyes are so beautiful, say, oh, they are beautiful, more beautiful than my eyes. That means you're comparing. So to remove the mentality of comparison, the Upanishad says, Apani Padao, he doesn't have hands, doesn't have legs, Arupam, Nirgunam. Why all these things are spoken in the Upanishads? So that we come to the position of understanding that Supreme Lord's form is transcendental and it is beyond matter. When it comes to description, we are limited to matter, so we know that hope. Thank you for that. Another beautiful verse. This is the last verse. I'll taste again. Stop the class.
Udir vidureti divya virupatam Shadavatram Badasarvari Muke Itikena Sadam Shriyojvalam Tulanam Marhatimat Priyananam.
Krishna Bharasni is telling Tulanam Marhatimat Priyananam. How can you ever compare, my dear Radharani, to moon or to a lotus? If you compare her face to a moon, when the sun rises, the moon disappears. When the sun rises in the day, the moon disappears. So if you compare Radharani's face to be like the moon, it is not possible, because Radharani's face is shining and so bright and so beautiful and wonderful, even in the daytime also. Suppose you compare Radharani's face to be the lotus. When the night appears, the lotus, it contracts itself. Iti kena tulayam. How can I compare my dear Radharani's face to be lotus? Because even during the night, in both day and night, sada, Shri Ojwalam. Just see, beautiful words. Krishna himself is glorifying Radharani. You just don't compare Radharani's face to lotus. Don't compare Radharani's face to be the moon. Because the moon disappears in the day and the lotus, it contracts in the night time. Whereas Radharani's face, Sada Shri Ojwalam. Avang managocharam yato vacho nivartante aprapya manasasaha. These are the statements in the Upanishad which talk about how glorification of Krishna by comparison is only a mental satisfaction only. Okay, we have done something. Because the scriptures say we are doing it, but actually they are not. To give you another simple way of describing it is, we know in the Upanishad there is a statement which says, Bala Agrashati Bhagasya Shasdat Kalpitasya Cha. The size of the soul is 1/10,000, the tip of the hair. A perfect measurement is given. And even the measurement is given, immediately described, Aprameyasya, the soul is immeasurable. If the soul is immeasurable, why the measurement is given? The measurement is only given to explain a principle. The soul is, the size of the soul is not 1/10,000 part of the tip of the hair. But why the size is given? Just to explain to you, as much as it is impossible to measure the size of the 1/10,000 part of the tip of the hair, in the same way, the soul is immeasurable. The size is only describing the immeasurability of the soul, but it is not giving the size of the soul. The same way, when we describe Krishna to be Ganashyama, is only to describe a given indication, that's all. Digdarshani. Give an indication, give an idea, but it is not a fact. Krishna's eyes are like lotus. It's just only to give an indication, but it's not a fact. Something much more. So we stop here. Any questions, please, to ask?
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, Dandavat Pranams, Angavishu Srila Prabhupada and Guru Maharaj. Wonderful, wonderful class, Prabhuji. I would say that there is no comparison to this class. Very nicely you explained that today you cleared my doubt why Upanishads are telling that he doesn't have this form, so that he doesn't have hands, legs or anything material, so that we, even if we compare, it's not going to make justice. So that's why. Thank you so much, Prabhuji. This very enlightening class.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Dandavat Pranam, Prabhu. Thank you, Prabhu, for a nice class and showing us one point, like how the comparisons are made, but it's not exact. Prabhuji, this you said the songs, right? The glorifications, the surrender part, then glorification. What was the next part, Prabhu, before prema part? You said dhyana or something. That part I didn't get, that Prabhu.
Surrender?
No, you said when surrender, you get, when the prayers are offered, right?
When you surrender, you get the qualification to glorify. When you glorify, your heart softens and becomes humble. In a softened and humble heart, prema manifests. In the prema, there is no other alternative other than crying by chanting the names of Krishna.
Yes, Prabhu. Okay.
The series goes. And then when you come back, then you go on paying obeisances again and again. And then at the end, when you come back to your consciousness, then you present your prayer, request for a prayer. Okay. The same Kuntimani prayers you see, Namami, surrender. Ishwatam prakrite param, alaksham sarabhutanam, glorification. Then humility. Katam pashyamahi striha. Oh, I am just a woman, what I can do even. For great Paramahamsas, you come and teach, who am I? And then she goes on doing Nam Sankirtan. Krishna Vasudevaya. And then he goes on paying obeisances again and again. And then at the end, she expresses her desire. Oh, please stay back for some more time. Like that. In the system of any prayer. Gajendra prayers, you find the same thing. Om Namo Bhagavate Tubhyam.
Yeah, Prabhuji, one statement, Prabhuji. Thank you, Prabhu, for that clarification. So can we say Mahaprabhu came to give the highest, to us? So here also, because he came to give Nam Sankirtan, and which is the highest, of any prayer or glorification. Is that the right analogy, Prabhu?
Yeah, Nam Sankirtan is nothing like that. Topmost. Nam Sankirtan is the topmost.
Yeah, thank you very much, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji, Dandavat Pranam. Thank you so much for the beautiful class. Prabhu, can you please explain me this point again, that you are telling that if Krishna is seeing that the person is not so pure, then he will remove away all the material things. But if a person is pure, then he will give the material things. Can you please elaborate that, Prabhu? Little confusing. Usually we hear, right, if devotee is more pure, then he will get removed of all of his material things and get closer to Krishna. But a little bit I got confused. Can you explain, Prabhu?
I'll give example. Not exactly, but you have a small child, a girl child, 5-year-old, 6-year-old child. Now she has a knife in her hand. What will you do? You will take away the knife. But when she becomes, say, 10, 11 year old, you give the knife, cut the sabji. You give the knife, you give the sabji and cause her to cut the sabji. Because now she is matured enough to deal with the knife and sabji. Whereas a 5-6 year old, and she was 5-6 year old, she's not matured enough. So only those who are renounced from matter, they can only deal with matter. To give another example, when a boy is perfectly trained as brahmachari, only that brahmachari is not interested in getting married should get married. Though the qualification of getting married is not being interested in getting married. Varaya udasina vattishtati. Udasina is carefree. Okay, getting married, somebody can put what to do, some responsibility. So the formula of dealing with matter means, one, he should be matured. Who can deal with money? Who knows how to use the money properly? Not everybody. So Krishna knows Dhruva Maharaj can do it. That is why he gave, okay, take entire kingdom. Srila Prabhupada told that Krishna is willing to give you entire New York. Why only few apartments, few land? But we are not qualified. That's the reason. If unqualified people have it in the hand, Krishna takes it. If unqualified devotees have it, he snatches. So maybe I give you examples which you can understand.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Child example was, knife example was very nice. Thank you, Prabhu. I could understand it clearly. Thank you so much for making it very simple. Hare Krishna. Very beautiful class.
We stop here now?
Yeah, yes, Prabhuji, if nobody has any question. If anybody have any question?
Prabhu, do you have time, Prabhuji?
For one question, because here is almost becoming 7 hours. 7 o'clock, another class. So please.
Okay, sorry, Prabhuji. So this is, we want to memorize the prayers and verses from Bhagavatam, like how you are saying, Prabhuji. So nice to hear the word-by-word meaning and thing. Can you give some ideas and tips how to memorize? Should we recite it daily or take one verse a day and memorize?
See, memory is according to one's karma. Don't bother about memory much. Somebody has got more memory, somebody has got less memory. That is not very important. What is important is practice. What is important is abhyasa. If you are able to even open and read the book every day, and somebody has memorized it but not doing every day, you are better. Because you are doing this swadhyaya, is recitation for the pleasure of Krishna every day. Krishna becomes more happy by you reciting the prayers, whether you read it from your memory or read it from the book. Krishna doesn't bother about it. Krishna bothers, are you have memorized but still not reciting? That is why Krishna is not happy with that person, that devotee. So don't bother about memory. Memory comes, well and good, Krishna's mercy. Krishna is the person who gives you memory. Krishna is the person who makes you forget. So let him make you remember. Let him make you forget. That is with Krishna. It is his job. Whatever he wants to do, let him do. But I want to serve Krishna. The best service to Krishna is to go in front of Krishna and read the verses. But one thing is, you should learn how to chant the verses. So even though you are not able to do perfectly, but try to do it according to the proper chanda. And that requires practice. So by reciting again and again, Krishna may give you put in your memory or may not put in memory. That is his headache. But we do our job. This is for the adults I'm talking about. But if you are a child, try to put in the memory. So it is the answer is not the same for everyone. But if you have a small 5-year-old, 3-year-old baby, I memorize and come, is that your teaching? Then that is not sadhana for them. What a 5-6-year-old sadhana? There's no sadhana for that, for the child. But for you it is sadhana. Oh, sorry. That is why, as adults, memory comes, Krishna's wish. Doesn't come, Krishna's wish. But as an offering to Krishna, actually, the Bhagavatam class, what's happening every day, so nicely you're all organizing it. I'm so happy that without temple, you're actually made an e-temple, electronic temple. So this is actually offering to Krishna. Vandanam. What does Vandanam mean? Vandanam means offering prayers to Krishna. What prayers we offer? Not our concocted prayers from the conditioned consciousness. What all prayers are there in the Bhagavatam? Prayers by the previous acharyas, the songs. You offer it to Krishna. One day, many years back when I joined our temple, earlier, we had only very few brahmacharis. And one day it so happened that we all had to go to some place. All the brahmacharis had to go to collect some kirana. So the bus was arranged and everybody went. I was the only person in the temple alone. And one pujari, that's all. So then Bhagavatam class I sat. I only put the Vyasasana and I sat in the Bhagavatam class. And sat Jayarada Madhu. The pujari told Prabhuji, nobody is there in the class. Why are you giving the class? Then I told Radha Giridhar is there, Jagannath Baldev Subhadra is there. He was shocked. You know, what do you mean by that? I said, this class. Then I asked him, why are you offering Bhoga? Nobody is there. Then he told Radha Giridhar is there, Jagannath Baldev Subhadra is there. So as much as Bhoga is an offering for Krishna, this Bhagavatam is also offering for Krishna. Whether somebody is there, nobody is there, but Krishna feels hungry, he has to eat. Just because somebody is not eating, he'll not eat at all. So in the same way, when somebody is not hearing, that doesn't make Krishna will not hear. So it's an offering for Krishna. That is how we should consider this. Memory, not memory, that is secondary. But that this formula doesn't apply for the children. Okay, Hare Krishna.
Thank you so much, Prabhuji, for your wonderful answer and association. It is very, very purifying, Prabhuji. A humble obeisances to you, Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Prabhuji, once again for such a beautiful class. Okay, we can end the call here. I would like to offer obeisances to all of the devotees and Prabhuji. Vancha kalpa taro bhyasya kripa sindhu bhyayeva cha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo nama. Ananta koti vaishnav vrinda ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai. His grace Kamal Lochan Prabhuji ki jai. Thank you so much, Prabhuji, for such a beautiful
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji, dandavat pranam.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you so much.